Hello students, welcome to an academy. This is your KP sir Krishna Prakash. Today our topic of discussion is changes in GATE 2021. IIT Bombay has come out with so many modifications in GATE. So today I will give a brief information, a precise and clear information regarding what are the changes happened in syllabus, what are the new models of questions added, what is two paper pattern system. Everything I will discuss with you. Before going to that, regarding myself, I taught more than 150 batches for GATE and DSE. I worked in India's all top coaching centers, and most of the students trained by me, they cracked GATE and IAS in a first attempt, and they got jobs. Most of the students of me working as assistant executive engineers in government sector, PSUs, and IAS officers also. Now, today's session, changes in GATE 2021, civil engineering. Only civil engineering students, not for other students, remember. Changes happened in GATE 2021 with respect to civil engineering students we are talking. So discussion about, first we'll talk about change in the syllabus. Then we'll discuss about weightage of the subjects. Then two paper system. Then models of MSQ question. By the end of the session, I will give you two or three MSQ questions so that you can understand what is the MSQ model also. Okay. Changes happened in GATE 2021. So with respect to syllabus, now we are writing changes happened in subject wise syllabus modification. Changes happened in subject wise syllabus modification. More changes happened, come across with fluid mechanics and hydraulic machinery. Most of the hydraulic parts from fluid mechanics is removed out. Kinematics of flow, velocity triangles, basics of hydraulic machines, specific speed of pumps and turbines. But actually, the weightage with respect to hydraulic machinery is very less. Mostly one question will come according to previous papers. That less weightage topics which are given in all subjects, not only fluid mechanics. Most of all subjects, what they did, whatever less weightage topics, those less weightage topics are removed out. Maybe one or two topics added additionally. So, with respect to fluid mechanics, hydraulic machinery. So, all these topics, kinematics of flow, velocity triangle, basics of hydraulic machinery, specific speed of pumps and turbines. When you observe a previous year question pattern, maybe 1 mark question 1 or 2 marks question 1 will come. Not a very high weightage coming from it. From this removed topics, I am talking about from removed topics. In addition to that, concept of lift and drag, a new topic added. So remember, from this concept of lift and drag, we are expecting one question compulsory in 2021 GATE. Because newly added, and also the topic is very important. Without lift forces, without drag forces, we can't solve any of the questions, most of the questions in fluid mechanics. So we are expecting 2021 sooner in concepts of lift and drag, followed by solid mechanics. The topic of theories of failure is taken out, removed out, and no new topic added. Don't worry, my dear students. No new topic added, only one topic, very confusing topic, no? Theories of failure. If your teacher is good, he will make it to simplify. But if you are not understanding it, if you are not listening properly, you can't get more in concept of theories of failure. So removing theories of failure will consider it is an advantage for a civil engineer. The next one, coming to my favorite subject, environmental engineering. We removed the topic of noise pollution, but very important. Na? Mostly every year one mark question or 1-2 marks question we are getting from noise pollution. But removing noise pollution, giving an indication that they will give more questions from air pollution, more questions from wastewater engineering, especially wastewater engineering. Previously, noise pollution is given weightage. So now as it was removed, we expect more questions from wastewater engineering. Then, air quality index and limits. Air quality index and limits, standard values of, permissible limits of particulate matter, PM5, PM10, PM25, PM50, gases, what are acceptable standards according to Indian condition. We have a list, we have a table, air quality index table. You need to by heart that permissible limits. Other than that, nothing more to worry about it. And some people said that water quality index added. Have you not studied water quality index previously? IS 10,500 standards. In my each and every class of quality analysis without water quality index, I have not taught anything. So water quality index is not a new topic added to you, my dear students. Don't confuse by other videos. Water quality index already you are studying in quality analysis of water. Second one, disposal and reuse of effluent. Already we are studying reuse of effluent through irrigation process. Disposal of effluent into the streams. So that topic also not a new topic. It's an old topic, just they have given one more heading. So don't worry about environmental. Only one topic added, air quality index and limits. So what are the reuse of effluent? You just go through side headings. If you require more, you want to study more, other than irrigation aspects. How effluent is again and again used, reused. Just you go through side headings, that is more than enough for disposal and reuse of effluent water. Coming for concrete structures. No more new topics. Very happy. Students will feel more happy now when topics are removed. Students will feel more happy. Syllabus is reducing. So same thing happened. Ultimate load design concepts. Analysis of beam sections at transfer and service loads. Have you seen more questions from any of the previous papers on these topics? I think nothing. Maybe one mark question out of 5 years or 4 years. So unimportant topics only they removed. Remember, not removed other than noise pollution. Other than noise pollution, all whatever removed is unimportant topics only. So in concrete also, ultimate load design concepts, analysis of beam section transfer and service loads. Engineering mechanics. Even for civil engineers, the least weighted subject, engineering mechanics only. 0 to 2 marks, maybe sometimes 0, sometimes 1, sometimes 2, not more than 2. Again, so many topics removed from it. Kinematics of point mass and rigid body, Euler's equations of motion, impulse momentum, energy method, principles of virtual load. So much our preparation reduced in mechanics, regarding mechanics, because less weighted subject we need, few topic only, they removed most of the topics which are not given previously. Along with that, they added one topic, free vibrations of undamped SDOF system. So we may expect one question from this, free vibrations of undamped SDOF system. Okay, so focus on this newly added topic of engineering mechanics. Maybe if you want to get one question, that one question is from this one, or free body diagram. So focus on this. Oh, transportation engineering. No addition in transportation engineering, remember? No addition, nothing added. Only topics are removed. Highway alignment, engineering surveys, design of bituminous paving mixes, distress in concrete and pavements, traffic, travel time delay, OD study, PCU, parking study, control devices, channelization, level of service of rural highways and urban roads. Previously, mostly one question will come from this. Means they have removed out all which are not given previously. That makes students to study very small number of topics, focus more and more depth. So you expect if they are removing more topics from your subject, from the remaining topics, they will ask you more depth questions. Be careful about it. So study well in the remaining topics, more in-depth concepts, because unnecessary not giving topics are removed out. So in remaining topics, they will ask more depth. So focus on that. Geotechnical. Origin of soils, soil structure and fabric, method of slices and Westergaard's theories. Without studying introduction, origin of soils, without studying soil structure and fabric. Will your geotechnical engineering is complete? It is incomplete only, no? So any teacher will start with this origin of soil, soil structure and fabric. So even though it is not in the syllabus, you have to go through it to understand remaining concepts of soil mechanics. Here, don't leave this. Even though it is not in your syllabus, you have to go through it because the basics of geotechnical engineering resides in it. Origin of soil, soil structure and fabric. Okay. Okay, remaining not given previously, also not given, no more weightage. Pile under lateral loading, pile group efficiency. So we are expecting in 2021, depending upon this question, pile group efficiency, we are expecting 2021 gate question. So be careful about added topics. First time they added means they will give mostly one question on the added topics. Focus on it. And then geomatics, GPS. Previously also from GPS, there are no more questions. Now also no need to worry. Irrigation, water logging, drainage, canal regulatory works, headworks, outlets and escapes. Have you seen any gate questions on this topic previously? Maybe one theory question from water logging. Other than that, no questions from canal regulatory work, headwork, outlets and escapes. So that no need to worry. There are no important topics are removed, only unimportant topics are removed from most of the subjects, not only irrigation, from most of the subjects. Same thing happened with CMM, construction material and management, bricks, mortar, timber and bitumen. We have questions from cement, we have questions from concrete only, we don't have questions from bricks, mortar, timber and bitumen. So this time you focus more on structural steel. Cement, you will get questions from it. So don't focus on these topics as they have been removed out. So engineering mathematics. New topic added is linear regression. New topic added is linear regression. Then removed topics are more. This is removed topics of engineering mathematics for civil engineers. Maclaurin series, Stokes, Gauss and Green theorem. Laplace transform, very important previously. Now Laplace transform removed, I don't know why. And its application in solving linear ODEs. So mostly we have one question on it, but now this time they have taken out. Hypothesis testing, least square approximation. But whatever removed topics in mathematics, they are having more weightage previously, questions are coming. But now they removed means they will do in-depth questions in the remaining syllabus. So be careful about that remaining syllabus. So newly added linear regression. Again, we expect one question from this linear regression. Don't miss the topic. You will have damn sure one question. We're expecting in 2021 linear regression. General aptitude. There are no more severe changes, but just they changed one name to other name. Just changed one name to other name. So added topics we have given. First of all, powers, exponents and logarithms. Permutations and combinations, mensuration and geometry, elementary statistics and probability. So generally you are studying this elementary statistics and probability in mathematics. And also you are studying permutations and combinations also in mathematics, is it not? Again, they have been added in and aptitude means more weightage is given to probability statistics. In the comment session written clearly, till now, permutations and combinations, elementary statistics and probability in mathematics, now added into quantitative aptitude also. Even though previously not given, but still quantitative aptitude section, they are giving it statistics and probability. So focus now more and more. Analytical aptitude. Analytical aptitude, they added logic, deduction and induction analogy. Numerical relations and reasoning. So you have to use your brain more. Focus on logical oriented questions. Apply your brain solving logical oriented questions. So, but already all these are previously part of verbal reasoning only. Just name changed. Analytical aptitude, verbal reasoning. Previously it is under verbal reasoning. Now it is given as a name, analytical aptitude. No new topic added here. spatial aptitude. This is spatial aptitude is related to non-verbal and visual reasoning, which is part of SSC JEE. Previously, it was the part of SSC JEE. Just now, they are included in GATE also. Transformation of shapes, translation, rotation, scaling, mirroring, assembling, grouping and paper folding, cutting patterns in two and three dimensions. Mostly banking sector exam, we are having these models. BSRB, RRB, SSC exams. These models are very more and more given. So now they are introduced into GATE. So you practice more questions from Verma and Agarwal book. Clear? Very good questions are there. If you take any bank coaching center material also, more questions you will get from spatial aptitude. So you focus on this non-verbal or visual reasoning. When you take SSC JEE books also, these questions are very high. So now we have finished changes in the syllabus. So don't worry regarding these changes. Once we'll go ahead. Just one topic added, lift and drag in fluid mechanics. One topic added, environmental engineering, air quality index and limits. Again, one topic added in engineering mechanics, free vibrations of undamped SDVOF system. Completely removed most of topics, unnecessary topics in transportation. Again, one more topic added in geotechnical. Pile under lateral loading, pile group efficiency. Total only four topics added in core syllabus. So students are worrying a lot regarding changes in syllabus. I don't know why. Topics are removed, yaar. No need to worry. You feel happy. But focus on newly added topics, okay? So all are removed only. In mathematics, that was added. Linear regression, very important. But more number of topics removed. Now, two paper system. A civil engineer student can write along with his core civil engineering paper. Again, one more paper. What are the papers eligible for the civil engineer? The two papers. He can write any one of the two papers. Architecture and planning, environmental science and engineering. So civil engineer can write along with his core civil engineering paper. He can have an option of choosing second paper. He can choose any one paper, architecture and planning, environmental science and engineering. With the same fees, don't worry about fees. While applying for the same civil engineering core, they will ask in the same application about second paper. What is going on in the second paper? Which is best for civil engineer? B.Tech civil engineer, which paper, which second paper is best? We'll go ahead. Architecture and planning. Total 10 core subject sections are there. Only one and only related to civil engineering. Construction and management, which include construction materials and management aspects. Remaining all 9 core subjects are not at all related to civil engineering. So can you choose it? You want to write a second paper, you have to study 9 different subjects. Again, 9 new subjects you have to focus. Only one subject is similar to it. So don't choose it. Blindly reject it. Architecture and planning and civil engineering paper are completely different. Don't waste your time on writing this paper. Environmental science and engineering. So there are so many topics related to it, exactly to our civil engineering paper. So I am giving 2 sessions here. One is the topics similar to GATE civil engineering. Another one is new topics to be prepared by a civil engineer for environmental science and engineering. So if you have chosen environmental science and engineering as your second paper, what already you are covering in civil engineering paper? Water resources engineering, environmental hydraulics, nothing but hydrology, irrigation, fluid mechanics, open channel flow, hydraulic machinery. All these are included. Water resources and environmental hydraulics, which include hydrology, irrigation, fluid mechanics, OCF, open channel flow, and HM. All these included. Any new for a civil engineer? Already the civil engineering student is preparing for these subjects only. No? We are having more weightage, OCF hydrology. But additionally, this time hydraulic machinery removed, you have to prepare it, no problem. So you are having hydrology, irrigation, fluid mechanics, OCF and HM. Subject 1. Subject 2. Water and wastewater treatment and management. Nothing but our environmental engineering. Is it not? Same we are studying the water supply engineering, wastewater engineering. Air and noise pollution. So in environmental engineering it is removed. According to GATE civil engineering, environmental engineering it is removed. But according to environmental science and engineering it is added. Air and noise pollution, solid and hazardous waste management. Already you are studying, any new for it? Around 65% of syllabus is similar to GATE civil engineering paper. So you prepared GATE civil engineering and you are writing subjects of environmental science and engineering. 65% of questions you can answer directly. Same like your civil engineering paper. But what are the new topics? Yes. These are completely blunder. No, not studied. Completely not studied by a civil engineer. New only. Environmental chemistry, environmental microbiology, global and regional environmental issues, environmental management and sustainable development. So new topics, these four subjects newly have to prepare. Instead of this, focus on the previous topics, math and apti. You will get around 70 marks from it. For remaining 30 marks, environmental management and sustainable development is easy subject, theoretical subject. Global and regional environmental issues also theoretical subjects. And these are helpful for you while if you are also preparing for ESC energy and environment, the two topics. So if you are also preparing for engineering service examination, you focus on these three, around 80 to 85% syllabus completed. Only for 15 to 20 marks you have to study new environmental chemistry and microbiology. Those students who are willing to write environmental science and engineering, contact me. I will guide you what to prepare, how to prepare, which material to follow. Clear? I will completely provide you guidance related to this environmental science and engineering because 100% related to me. Full syllabus is related to me. So I will take care about your preparation. If you are willing to give your effort to crack environmental science and engineering. Okay. Then these are the paper system, architecture and planning out of syllabus for us. No need. Don't choose it. If you want to select a second paper, select environmental science and engineering. Then coming for multiple select questions means it carry one or more than one choice as correct answer. So it is objective oriented question only, no doubt about it. Objective oriented question, A, B, C, D options are there. In that A, B, C, D, one may be answer. One means, for example, C may be answer. Sometimes what happened? A and C will be answer. B and C and D may be answer. One or more than one choice will be present. But advantage of this, no negative marks. So that you can try for it. As the negative marks are there, you can skip. But no negative marks, you can try for it, no issue. And no partial credit means, for example, out of four options, A and D are given correct. But you have answered A only. They don't give you half mark. Don't expect that. If you give A and D, then they will give full marks. If you have not chosen D, you have chosen A, they won't give you half mark. Do you remember? There is no partial credit for it. There is no partial credit for it. Means a question which carry one or more than one option is given as multiple select question. When I say this, most of the students are asking me, sir, how to identify multiple select? They won't give this is multiple select question, this is not multiple select question. Okay? They won't give such kind of model. They have given, easily you can identify it. So by reading a theoretical MCQ question, objective question, you can go through in depth of subject, you can analyze the question and you can finalize whether it is MSQ or it is MCQ. So don't expect the GATE IIT to give you this is multiple select, so answer multiple select. No, they won't give like that. Okay. And to know more about it before starting the exam of GATE, there will be some instructions. you go through instructions, study the instructions, read the instructions properly, so that if there is a such kind of facility provided, like we will mention multiple select question as multiple select, so you are very happy. But mostly, according to me, mostly they won't give such kind of facility to you. So by chance, if there is a facility you don't want to miss, read instruction before starting the exam. That instructions will give you clarity related to MSQ. Okay, we'll go through few MSQ questions related to my favorite subjects. Identify list of primary air pollutants. What are list of primary air pollutants in the given? Smog, CO, CO2. In this, smog is a secondary air pollutant, na? So this is eliminated. NO2, nitrogen dioxide, hydrocarbons, soot. Yes, this is primary. Aerosols, sulfur dioxide, dust. This is also primary. So now the multiple select answer is B and C. Don't go for all the above, because a smog is a secondary. So not all the above is not the answer. So B and C is the answer for it. Multiple select question, primary air pollutants, B and C is the answer. Which of the following is slash R are the functions of? So this is one of the indication for you. They are given a is or are. So by this, if they have given like this, easily you can identify. Is or are means more than one may be present. So that it is easy for you to identify functions of aeration. Aeration will perform removal of color, no doubt. Aeration is not performing desalination. Aeration is not a method of softening, but aeration is carried out to increase DO content. So answer is A and D. Clear? Answer is A and D. Clearly mentioned information to you, then you check, recheck, recheck whether it is MSQ or it is MCQ, because mentioned is slash R. Again, same, is slash R. Which of the following empirical equations is slash R used for measurement of evaporation? Only they are asking about empirical. And Penman's equation, not at all related to it, we remove it. Mayer's equation, Fitzgerald's equation, Rohr's equation. B, C and D. So MSQ question, it is Mayer's equation, Fitzgerald's equation, Rohr's equation. Answer is B, C, D. Bicarbonates of calcium causes. Very simple question. Bicarbonates of calcium causes which of the following hardness? Temporary. Calcium and bicarbonates. Bicarbonates given. So temporary, no doubt. Non-carbonate. No, no. Temporary is carbonate hardness. So carbonate hardness. A and C. The very best suggestion to solve theoretical question. Read all options before answering the question. Analyze, think about all options, then only finally choose the answer. By observing just temporary hardness, you got it option A and gone to next question. There is option C, carbonate hardness. Both are the answers, A and C. So be careful while answering theoretical question. Okay. So this ends the changes in GATE 2021. Because 1 hour, 2 hours videos does not give you any information. I don't want to waste your time. In a short duration, the complete information related to changes in GATE I have given to you. More than this, no need to understand, no need to know anything regarding changes. These are the only changes related to GATE. Then, in plus course, in an academy, I'm going to teach the subjects environmental engineering, hydrology, irrigation, OCF, construction materials and management. The weightage of these subjects in GATE is 25 marks. So, I am teaching very well. Environmental engineering, I am spending 140 hours. So, you understand depth of the subject. Hydrology, 60 hours. Irrigation, 60 hours. Open channel flow, 30 hours. Construction material and management, 40 hours. This many hours I am spending. In-depth subject concept, N models of questions I will teach. Understand the importance of plus course, okay? If you are taking using my code, K KP Civil. Using my code KP Civil or Engineering Guru, you will get a 10% discount, one free online test series, free scanned copies of notes and other materials required for GATE examination. And I will support you till end of your GATE preparation, cracking GATE, getting a PSU job or joining in a NIT or IIT. No faculty will support you if you join a coaching center. So join with the faculty support, then only you achieve your dream. So we are going to launch a new batch of environmental engineering soon. So take your plus subscription. And if you have any doubts or you have any kind of queries, you want to know something regarding your career, you want to know how to write environmental science and engineering second paper, WhatsApp me 8985933112. While joining plus subscription, use my code KP Civil. Okay, clear for everyone? I'm going to close the session. Thank you one and all. Bye bye.